Ugh, that's gonna take a while. Sometimes, scripts just run longer than you wish they would. If you're on a remote computer, this might mean you need to keep your laptop running. And even then, you might experience a connection timeout, which usually means you'll have to restart your task. In this video, we will discuss multiple solutions for this issue, one of which might even work when the task is already running. First, we'll take a look at the nohub command. This is probably the easiest solution. Just put nohub before your command, and it will make sure your command won't be interrupted by hangup signals. Output will be written to a file called nohub.out, which you can check using tools like cat or tail. This solution works quite well, however, you won't have any control over your task. If you need that, you might want to look into GNU Screen or Tmux. Up until a few years ago, most distributions included a tool called Screen. This still is a quite popular tool for long-running tasks on remote systems. To run your task in a screen, just type screen and start your script or whatever it is you need to run, just like you would without it. Now you can detach your session by hitting Ctrl+A and then D for detach. You can reconnect to your screen session later by running screen-r. If you have multiple screen sessions open, it will tell you so, and you can connect to a specific one by supplying the right ID. This ID represents the actual PID or process ID of your screen session, which you can check using the ps command, like this. If you'd like to scroll up to see what happened before, you can push Ctrl+A again, followed by the escape key to enable scrollback mode. Now you can scroll up and down using the arrow keys or the page up and page down keys on your keyboard. Press escape again to exit scrollback mode. If you want to stop your screen, just type exit or hit Ctrl+D just like you would in any other shell session. GNU Screen has of course way more functions than this, but before you look into them, it might be interesting to check a more modern variant called Tmux. You can use Tmux pretty much in the same way as Screen. Just type Tmux, press enter and run your script. To disconnect, you hit Ctrl+B followed by a D to detach. To reconnect, type tmux attach or just tmux A. To scroll, enter copy mode by hitting Ctrl+B and an open bracket. Now you can use the cursor keys and the page up and down keys to scroll. To quit copy mode, press Q. To quit tmux, you can again just close your session by typing exit or hitting Ctrl+D. And now an interesting feature of Tmux, control mode. If you're using a terminal client that supports it, like iTerm on a Mac, it can be cool to run Tmux with --C C. This will start Tmux in control mode and gives the client full control over it. Now you can just open a new tab and it will create an extra Tmux session without having to log in again. This can be very useful at times. You can disconnect and reconnect later and find all your tabs still working. Isn't that awesome? Of course, Tmux as well has way more to offer, but I'll leave you to find out about that yourself. Now, what if you started a task and noticed it will run way longer than you had expected, or simply forgot to open screen or Tmux before? You might already know that you can push a task to the background by pausing it with Ctrl+Z and then running BG. You can see your task using the jobs command, and you can bring it back to the foreground running FG. This still doesn't disconnect the task from your session though, and as soon as your session is closed, the task will most probably die. If your command doesn't need a full user session, you can also run disown to disconnect the process from your session. Now you can just close your session and your task will happily keep running. If you'd like to reconnect with your task, you can try the reptar command. This command allows you to attach an already running process to the current terminal. Find the process ID of your script and run reptar followed by that ID. You can also do this inside a screen or tmux session. Whew, saved! Now, not everything will reconnect like this though. Your mileage may vary, so to say. Probably better to use one of the previous commands, but this might work when your script is taking way longer than you expected and you don't want to restart. Now that's all I have for you today. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching. Until next time.